makes a hero? Is it someone who saves somebody from harm and destruction? Or perhaps, is it someone who plays as somebody who saves somebody from harm and destruction? This week's game review, Spider-Man 2, The Game.
Okay, so I'll summarize the story for you. Peter Parker, busy. Spider-Man, burden. Dr. Otto Octavius, good and want to help Earth, until Magnum Opus thing fails. Rosie, dead. Otto, now Doc Ock, because arms make crazy, now bad and want to steal and destroy and complete thing. Spider-Man, stop Doc Ock from crazy and world by. I don't think any of you could put it any better. Of course, this being a video game adaptation, there are varieties of new events involving more villains that interweave between the events of the movie. So you'll see classic villains from the Marvel Universe such as Mysterio, Shocker, and Rhino. The presentation is definitely interesting. If you were to judge the game by the cutscenes alone, you would be under the impression of the game having a realistic approach. Instead, it goes for the slightly stylistic direction of kinda looking like a comic book, while being accompanied by the three leading roles of the film reprising their character's voice for the game. So you can see why it might be a little confusing hearing Tobey Maguire's voice coming out of his character model counterpart that looks like this.
Sorry, Harry.
In fact, all of the in-game models look polygonal, but keep in mind it isn't the character models that is going to make you want to replay this game. However, Spider-Man does have the best looking character animations, as it should, because I mean, you're playing a game about Spider-Man. By all means, it is no Ultimate Spider-Man in terms of style, but these bad guys are really over the top, carrying toaster-sized guns that shoot 50 caliber rounds, while some are rocking the ever-so-popular wrench. It's like half of these guys surfaced straight out of Rapture and decided to take residence in New York City and give Spider-Man a hard time. New York City is pretty darn beautiful though. For a PlayStation and Xbox console title, the city is freaking huge, and going from the streets to the rooftops, it doesn't get any better than this. The one fallback I would say are the voice performances that are not Toby, Kirsten, and Alfred Molina. It's like everyone else in the game are caricatures, like this little kid's voice.
Hey Spidey, is your refrigerator running? 'Cause I sure am!
Oh wait, I forgot about Russell Huxtable, J. Jonah Jameson. However, all of the supporting villains, in my opinion, fit extremely well, and Toby's performance in the game is spot on. Spider-Man becomes very relatable as each bit of dialogue sucks you into Peter's personal life. Oh, and you can't forget about his Spidey retorts.
Been meaning to ask, how's your absorbency compared with the leading brand?
There are three tiers of activities you can do as the wall crawler. There is the main story that honestly you can beat in about one sitting because of how short it is. There are random encounters which can vary from saving a woman in the middle of a burglary or saving a balloon for a child, which is... You can talk to people that will trigger events for Spidey to do, such as rescuing someone, stopping a speeding vehicle, or defeating a bunch of bad guys. Finally, there are side missions that are a bit more difficult. These consist of delivering pizzas, taking photos for the Bugle, and meeting up with Mary Jane before she thinks you bailed on her. Again. Completing each activity will reward you with things called hero points that you can cash in for upgrades at the Spidey store. There is a good bit of stuff to do, and not to mention a freaking ton of things to collect. So like any sandbox title, you gotta mix in the main quest with side missions to really make sure things don't get too repetitive. This is the Spidey title that introduced accurate swinging, where you can only shoot web based on your surroundings, and if you are no longer surrounded by buildings, be prepared to fall. This is what makes Spider-Man Spider-Man. New York City. You can't just put Spidey in Wichita, Kansas, where everything is flat and the tallest things around you are trees and those fan things. It's other Spider-Man titles like, oh, I don't know, that make swinging more visually appealing, but I don't feel like Spider-Man. I feel like I'm watching him as he attaches webs to clouds. Why do you think people constantly defend the Wii, even when others are like, oh, but it looks so bad? It goes to show you if you have a game that plays fantastic and looks like the doo-doo is way better received than a game that looks real and plays like the doo-doo. The jump meter is what makes this, in my opinion, the game changer compared to any other Spider-Man title out there. And before you go all, oh, but you can charge jumps in other Spider games, yeah, but they aren't represented by a meter. There is a reason this meter is emphasized. If you charge the meter and release it at the top of your swing, Spidey will then vertically ascend. At the bottom of your swing, releasing jump will shoot you horizontally, gaining more distance than air. On top of all of that, hitting the left trigger while swinging will give you an extra speed boost. So, already with these three simple mechanics, swinging becomes an art of precision. Done are we with the days that you held down the right trigger and alternated Spidey's height in the air with two other buttons. Oh wait, you know what does that? Spider-Man not only does he swing, but you can also wall crawl, wall jump, wall sprint, and web zip throughout the city. Being Spider-Man has never been this expressive, which leads me to the next thing, the Spidey store. This concept works really well in this game, because how boring would it be if developers were like, oh, so Spider-Man would have everything, so let's give them everything to go and stop Dr. Octopus. Not only are there fighting upgrades as you would expect, but my favorite thing about the store is that there are swinging upgrades. Not only can you upgrade your swing speed level, but you can also unlock things like the slingshot jump, web zip, and air tricks. These air tricks aren't even necessary to completing the game, but why wouldn't you want them? It's like they know they are keeping you from being the best Spider-Man you can be, and you want to be able to do everything he can possibly do, even if it's just twirling in the air. Even the fighting combinations are pretty cool. It's definitely not a super tight fighting and dodging system like in the Arkham titles, but it works fairly well. I personally like to grapple the last enemy and take him to the highest building and just throw him. Goodbye, child. I'd rather be that guy than have to chase Black Cat. Look at her character model. She's just a little too mature, if you get what I'm saying. And she kind of sucks at being desirable.
Are these yours?
Please.
Wait!
But you know what J. Jonah Jameson has to say.
Oh, young men in love will do crazy things.
Epic mode engaged. Though the game itself is a little short, it's still one of my personal favorites of this day. You'll find yourself doing nothing but swinging and ignoring the rest of the world around. The lead voice acting is wonderful, the other villains add a nice touch, and the swinging is just breathtaking. There is a good bit to do after it's all said and done, but you're going just to come back to this game just to swing around, and maybe save some people. Just maybe. I'm seriously hoping that the second Amazing Spider-Man movie is as amazing as the sequel starring Tobey Maguire. I also hope that its video game counterpart does things right. Anyways, I give Spider-Man 2, the game, 9 web cartridges out of them tins.
Thanks for tuning in to Dem Games. It is a very new series. I'm going to be trying to do a video each week. It either being like a top 10 or a video game review or something else that will differ me from other video game reviewers around YouTube. Hopefully that will get everyone's attention. I'm not gonna say what that is quite yet, but I think it's going to be great and I'm super, super excited to be doing some stuff like that. Anyways, I'm Youngtown. Thanks again for tuning in and I'll see you next time.
If you are wanting to watch more Dem Games, check the animated box. Also, Youngtown is on Twitter, so follow him so that you are notified. Also, like, subscribe, and share this video to Dem friends. Thank you. Have a wonderful evening. Or day. Or life.